Welcome. I'm Dennis Sparger, Music Director of the Bach Society of St. Louis. Thank you for joining us today for a special performance of Bach arias by some of the most sought-after Baroque singers of our time. This program is part of the 2021 St. Louis Bach Festival, sponsored by Centene Charitable Foundation. Most of the selections you're about to hear are core to the St. John Passion, a central focus of the Bach Festival this season. If you attend Bach Society concerts, you've met these exceptional singers already, but now you get to see and hear them close up. I think you'll be impressed. Joining us today from Chicago is a native of the Netherlands, soprano Josefien Stoppelenburg. From Liberty, Missouri, countertenor Jay Carter. From New Haven, Connecticut, tenor Gene Stenger. From Seattle, baritone Elijah Blaisdell. And from Montreal, bass baritone Alex Dobson. Now sit back and enjoy Bach Sings, a concert of arias.
Hi, I'm Alexander Dobson, baritone, and this is pianist Julien LeBlanc. We are thrilled that the Bach Society of St. Louis has asked us to do this little performance of two Bach arias. It is very kind of them, and we thank them very much to let us make music during this troubled time. The first aria we will be performing is from St. Matthew Passion, Gebt mir meinen Jesum wieder. Judas, who has betrayed Christ, feels such remorse and runs back to the high priest, pleading with them, "Give me back my Jesus." But it is too little, too late.
Seht das Geld im Medellon, wirft euch der Pellorne schon zu den Füßen nieder. Im Edelon, wirft euch der Pellorne schon zu den Füßen nieder. Seht das Geld im Edelon, wirft euch der Pellorne schon zu den Füßen nieder. Geht mir einen Jesum, einen Jesum, geht mir meinen Jesum wieder, meinen Jesum geht mir wieder, geht mir meinen Jesum wieder, geht mir meinen Jesum wieder, meinen Jesum wieder.
Good afternoon, and it's good to sort of virtually see you all greetings from my studio here in Kansas City. It's not the medium that I usually have an opportunity to interact with audiences in, but I suppose it'll do for now. I was really happy to be contacted by the Bach Society and have the opportunity to record these two arias from the John Passion, primarily because it was an opportunity to interact with audiences even in the midst of the ongoing health crisis, but also because it gave me an opportunity to reach out to my collaborator Keith Weber and recital partner based in Houston while I was there on another recording project, and to have an excuse for us to get together and to make music with one another. And so this was the perfect opportunity to do that. There are two arias that we recorded for you from the John Passion, both of the alto arias that are contained in the John Passion. The first, Von den Stricken meiner Sünden, From the Shackles of My Sin, is an aria from very near the beginning of the John Passion, where the evangelist is telling the story of Christ's arrest and being led off away by the authorities. And Bach does what he often does in the Passions, where he pauses the action and an aspect of what has just happened in the previous scene is commented upon. And in this case, Christ's arrest becomes an opportunity for the alto aria soloist to ruminate on the notion of Christ being made to pay the price for the sins of humanity. And the inevitability of that seems to be indicated in the piece by this notion in the A section of this consistently repeating bass gesture that you'll hear very carefully if you listen, that goes away during the B section and then comes back with even more inevitability when the A section is repeated.
Thank you. my name is Josefien Stoppelenburg, and I'll be performing two arias for you from Bach's St. John Passion. The first one is a very happy aria. It depicts the Christian perspective of following Christ. And you'll hear in the chamber organ that the left hand depicts the happy steps, so to speak, and the right hand, normally played by two flutes, in this case just one right hand up there, depicts the following. So you can really hear the voice imitating or following the flute as to depict the following of Christ.
Aria that we'll be presenting today is the tenor aria Ach, mein Sinn, or Ah, my Soul, from Bach's St. John Passion. Before this aria, the evangelist, or the narrator, reveals that the disciple Peter has denied Jesus three times. Peter then remembers that Jesus told him, "Before the cock crows, you will deny me three times." After this realization, Peter weeps bitterly, and the passionate tenor aria is a reflection of Peter's both anguish and remorse. These intense emotions are depicted in the jagged dotted rhythms found in both the vocal line and the orchestration of the aria.
ich mich erquicken? Ach, wo soll ich mich erquicken? Ach, mein Sinn, wo willst du endlich hin? Ach, mein Sinn, wo willst du endlich hin? Ach, mein Sinn, wo willst du endlich hin? Wo willst du endlich hin? Ach, mein Sinn, wo willst du endlich hin? Wo soll ich mich erquicken? Wo willst du endlich hin? Wohin? Wo soll ich mich erquicken? Wo soll ich mich erquicken? Bleib ich hier? Oder wünsch ich mir Bett und Hügel auf den Rücken?
My name is Elijah Blaisdell, and this is my collaborator, Elisabeth Ellis. I'm very sad I wasn't able to join you all this year in St. Louis, or last year, for that matter, but I'm very grateful to be able to join you virtually in this way. Before we jump into this piece, I wanted to say a few words. In this arioso, we take a minute to reflect while Jesus is being scourged. What Bach has given us here is a beautiful and yet tentative celebration of Jesus' suffering. It asks our souls to contemplate with anxious pleasure and with bitter joy how out of his suffering will spring the key to our salvation, ending with the exhortation to look upon Jesus unceasingly. This is Betrachte meine Seele.
Bild reinlost und
The second aria that we'll be presenting today also comes from the St. John Passion and is the tenor aria Erwäge wie sein blutgefärbte Rücken. This aria comes from part two of the Passion, and the text describes how the greatest good comes out of Jesus' suffering. The text translates as, "Imagine how Jesus' blood-stained back is like heaven. After the deluge from the flood of our sins has abated, a beautiful rainbow appears, representing a depiction of God's grace. This heavenly depiction of grace is also found in the moving harmonies found in the accompaniment."
Alle Türen
Es ist vollbracht is from near the end of the Passion. And it takes, again, like von den Stricken, words from the Evangelist and spins them out into a sort of devotional on the material that's just been spoken of. Es ist vollbracht is one of the sayings of Christ. You hear about the seven words of Christ from the cross. This is the last setting of text that Christ actually says. Es ist vollbracht. It's accomplished. It's made complete. It's finished. And Bach takes that text and spins it out into the basis of an aria for alto and an obbligato viola da gamba, which looks a bit like a cello but has its own unique sound and qualities to it. And Es ist vollbracht sounds rather morose in the beginning and starts in the kind of heavy, difficult key of B minor. But the interesting thing about music is that B minor and D major, the key of triumph and victory, share a key signature with one another. And Bach very expectedly takes the kind of heavy, burdensome B minor aspects of the A section of Es ist vollbracht and spins it out into a B section of the piece in D major that seems incredibly triumphant and heroic. As that D major section and the B section of the aria continues on, it's immediately concluded with a very harmonically interesting chord, one that stops the action, and then the text, Es ist vollbracht, comes back again, indicating that the struggle has come to an end, albeit not in the way that some people would generally think of a struggle being ended.
Thank you.
This next aria is a charmingly forward and, I would say, somewhat myopic interrogation of Jesus on the cross. The singer asks of Jesus, "Now that you're nailed to the cross, am I saved? Do I get to go to heaven now? Do we all get to go to heaven?" Over the past year, I found myself relating more and more to this piece, as I find myself wanting to say to my friends and family, "I know that you're suffering like we all are, but am I going to be okay? Am I going to make it through this?" Musically, this aria has a lot going on too. You'll hear fragments of a chorale, which would be sung by the whole choir were we able to be together in St. Louis. The text they sing is from the final verse of the chorale, "Jesu leiden, pein und tod," which translates to Jesus' suffering, pain, and death. This has the effect of both anchoring and commenting on the soloist's faster-moving queries of Jesus. You'll also hear a lot of interplay and imitation between the basso continuo line and the soloist line, my line. I hope you enjoy this aria as much as I have. Here is Mein teurer Heiland.
Mein teurer Heiland, lass dich fragen, teurer Heiland, lass dich fragen, teurer Heiland, lass dich fragen. Ans Kreuz geschlagen und selbst gesagt, es ist vollbracht. Bin ich vom Sterben frei gemacht? Bin ich vom Sterben frei gemacht, vom Sterben frei gemacht? Bin ich vom Sterben frei gemacht, vom Sterben frei gemacht? Durch deine Pein und Sterben, das Himmelreich ererben. Ist aller Welt Erlösung da, aller Welt Erlösung da. Du kannst vor Schmerzen zwar nicht sagen, vor Schmerzen zwar nicht sagen, doch neigest du das Haupt, doch neigest du das Haupt und sprichst, doch neigest du das Haupt und sprichst, stillschweigend. Stillschweigend, ja, doch neigest du das Haupt und sprichst stillschweigend, ja.
The second aria, Zerfließe mein Herze, melt my heart into tears. This comes towards the end of the Passion, when the realization kicks in that Christ is dead. So it's a strong emotional reaction to his death, to that realization. And we can really hear the flowing of the tears in the music, and also kind of a sobbing sort of movement, yadam, padam, padam. So it's a piece drenched in grief.
Thank you.
The next aria we'd like to perform is from Bach Cantata 59. The aria is called Die Welt mit allen Königreichen. In this aria, the world is depicted as a glorious place, but heaven is splendorous. And no matter what we have on earth and we feel it is good, it will be much better in heaven.
Selection we'll be presenting today is the tenor aria Frohe Hirten, or Happy Shepherds, from Bach's Christmas Oratorio. This aria comes from the second cantata of the Christmas Oratorio, representing the second Christmas day. In this happy and delightful aria, the shepherds are urged to hurry to see the newborn Christ child lying in the manger. This excitement is depicted in the long melismatic vocal lines that you'll hear later in the aria.
Thank you. Herz und Seele.